Hey, what's up, champions? How's it going? Gediminas here. Hope you guys are doing very well. Hope you had an awesome week. Great start of February. Hopefully you're rocking and rolling. Alright, if you're watching a replay, please do me a massive favor and stick hashtag replay into the comments so that I can see who watched the replay and who watched the live. And if you're brand new, if you're watching one of my videos for the first time, do say new in the comments, right? So that I can say hello, I can connect with you, say hi. And if you're watching a live, do say hello in the comments. Hey Irina, thank you for watching, even though you're literally sitting across the couch from me. But she's tuning in, she wants to be the supporter, you know, giving me some thumbs up, and I appreciate that a lot. Hey Janos, hey Esther, hey Ludmila, hey Irina, hey Josephine, hey Renata, hope you guys are doing well. Hey Georgina, all right. So happy Saturday, guys. Hopefully you had an awesome week. So today I wanted to share with you 5 rules for leadership. Right. So if you're aspiring to be a leader in network marketing, or maybe you're already a leader or you already have a team, then listen up, because these 5 rules might help you just to become a better leader, or maybe to lead in a better way. OK, so rule number one, you can get whatever you want in network marketing, but not by stopping other people from getting what they want. Okay, so you can get whatever you want in network marketing, but not by stopping other people to get what they want. What do I mean by that? There's a lot of people in network marketing, and unfortunately, there's a lot of leaders in network marketing who make a habit of putting other people down, who make a habit of making other people feel bad, or who make a habit of making other people feel small or inferior to them, etc. That's one of the worst things you can do as a leader. Actually, as a leader, you should be the complete opposite. You should be always lifting your people up. You should be always inspiring your people. You should be always promoting your people. And that's what real leaders do. Real leaders don't push themselves forward, but they push their people forward. They promote their people. They say, yeah, I know. Thanks for all the compliments. But have you seen this leader that I have in my team? Oh, yes. Thank you for this award. That's awesome. But have you seen this leader that I have on my team? That's what real leaders do. They promote other people. They inspire other people instead of pushing other people down to feel better themselves, pushing other people down to feel, to show up that I'm a bigger leader than them. That's the worst thing you can do, you know, spreading rumors about other people, talking behind other people's backs, etc. You know, and for me personally, whenever I have people talking behind my back, I'm happy. Because it means that I'm at the front. If they're talking behind my back, that means I'm at the front. So it's totally cool. Okay. So that's rule number one, right? Rule number two is purple fever. Now, what is purple fever? Well, actually, purple fever was discovered long time ago in medicine. You know, when doctors were delivering babies, a lot of mums were dying. You know, when they were delivering babies, a lot of moms would get sick and die. And they were like, what is causing? There must be like this fever that's spreading, etc. And actually, later on, they realized that it was because they didn't wash their hands between the deliveries. They were spreading bacteria and the moms were dying after giving birth. And it was called purple fever, right? So what does it mean? They were looking for all the reasons why these moms are dying, but they were the problem. The doctors were the problem. The doctors were causing those deaths because they were spreading the bacteria with their hands because they were not washing. And when they started washing their hands with chlorine, the deaths stopped, right? So they were the problem, but they were looking for a problem everywhere. So as a leader, sometimes you have to step back and look if the problem is not you. You know, like, for example, when somebody says, oh, somebody left my team. They went to another company. You know, somebody left my business. They went to another business. Oh, they're so bad. Oh, you know, that another person that took them from my team are so bad. You know what? I blame me. If somebody leaves my team and goes to another company, it's not their fault. It's not the person who stole them. It's their fault. It's my fault. Because if I really work hard with that person, if I'm really like that with them, if I'm really holding them, if I'm really helping them to get results, if I'm really supporting them, then they shouldn't leave my team. They shouldn't go to another company. You understand what I'm saying? So sometimes if you're experiencing challenges in your business, if you're experiencing difficulties in your business, sometimes you have to step back and look, am I actually causing that problem? Am I actually causing that difficulty in my business? I know it's not easy. I know it's difficult to admit your own fault, but sometimes it's the most powerful revelation you can get in your business. So that's step number two, right? Step number three is if you want to become successful, you have to be willing to help others as a leader and also to ask for help, which is probably the hardest lesson, you know, because most people are too proud. Most people's ego is right here, right? So they will do everything not to ask for help. They will do everything not to reach out to somebody and say, hey, I'm struggling. Hey, can you help me out? Hey, can you give me some advice, right? And it's like one of my mentors used to say, if you were drowning, would you drown quietly? If you were in the water and you were drowning, would you just go, oh, let me just drown quietly? I don't want to disturb anybody. Would you do that? Or would you scream for help? Help, help, I'm drowning, right? You'd probably scream for help so that somebody come and save you, right? But a lot of people are drowning in business and they're drowning quietly. They're not selling anything. They're not recruiting anybody. They're not getting any support, but they're just drowning quietly, right? Don't do that. If you're struggling, if you're not getting results, if you're not where you want to be, ask for help. Because there's plenty of people out there who are willing to help. Oh my gosh, we've got some legends in the house. Mr. Fraser Brooks, right? And Fraser's 100th episode is coming up, guys. Don't miss that one, right? You have to be there, okay? So make sure you ask for help and you help others. You know, as a leader, you need to be helping people in your business. Right? Don't just recruit people and leave them. Don't just recruit people. You know, my mentality when I first started in network marketing, my idea of being a leader was throw them against the wall and see who sticks. Right? That was my idea. Now, Irina just started playing a video. So you're going to hear me twice, right? So that was my idea as a leader. So the last thing, you know, you want to do is do that. You know, you want to make sure the people that you do bring onto the business, you support them, you look after them, you help them to reach their goals. You help them to get where they want to get into the business, right? So that's step three for the leadership, right? Advice number three. Advice number four for leadership is leaders speak the last. You know, I think it was Nelson Mandela who said that, you know, his father was a great leader. He was, I think, like a king or whatever, you know, in South Africa. And he said, as a kid, I noticed that when the heads would, the leaders would gather, he would go, my father would speak the last instead of trying to speak the first. So again, a lot of people who are not great leaders, they try to push their message first. They try to push their agenda first. But as a true leader, what you want to do is speak last. Listen to what everybody else said. Listen to what everybody else got to say. And sometimes by not rushing to put your opinion, by not rushing to give your answer, you'll realize that the real problem was different from what you thought initially that there is a real problem or the real challenge or whatever. So sometimes you just need to sit back and listen out, hear the person out. You know, if they stop to breathe in, not that they stop talking, right? So true leaders speak last. They hear out, they sit down, they hear everybody out, and then they deliver their message, and then they deliver their impact, right? So become a great listener as a leader. You know, hear people out and you'll see, again, it's going to help you a lot in your business. You know, one of the things I do with my leaders, we do coaching sessions, and I ask and I listen. I ask and I listen. I'm just asking questions and I'm letting them talk to me. I'm letting them say the things that they have inside of them. And I hear things that I've never heard before. Right? So that's step number four. And step number five, you need to understand that whatever leadership you reach, whatever position you reach, whatever rank you reach, whatever check you reach, it doesn't belong to you. It belongs to the people who have put you up there. Because the only reason why you're a leader, the only reason why you're making the money you're making, the only reason why you're getting the card that you're getting from the company, the only reason why you're getting the respect and the admiration is thanks to the people in your team. If not the people in your team, you wouldn't be where you are. So you don't deserve respect. You don't deserve admiration. You don't deserve the red carpets. You don't deserve for people to fall under your feet and adore you and glorify you because you're so great. Because everything that you are is thanks to the people who actually are in your team. It's thanks to your leaders underneath you, in your team, who are working hard to build the businesses, etc. So always send it back out to them. Always thank them for that. Always respect them for it. Always appreciate them for that. Because it's because of those people that you are where you are in that position. You know, if it wasn't for them, if it wasn't for their hard work, if it wasn't for their dedication, you wouldn't be in that position where you are today. You wouldn't be making money. Or maybe you're not there yet, but once you get there, you have to remember, you know, don't become full of yourself. Don't become, you know, full of that ego that, oh, look at me, I'm the King Kong here, you know, like I don't pay for the meeting, I don't do this or that, etc. Right? Because the only reason why you're there is because of the work of your team. Is because of the work of your leaders, right? That's the only reason why you're there. So, you know, stay humble. Remember where you came from and remember what helped you to get to that position, okay? So these are my 5 rules for leadership. Hopefully you got some value from that. If you did, feel free to share this video. Maybe somebody needs to hear that message and it will help them too. And if you're already in home-based business and you like my 26 different strategies, how to get more customers and how to get more sales, then head over to titaniumsuccess.co.uk/sales and you'll be able to download my free audio with 26 different strategies on how to get more customers and sell more products. Have an awesome evening, guys, and I'll see you at the top. Love you loads. Thanks very much for all the support. Thanks, Ludmila. Thanks, Leanne. Thanks, Anna. Thanks, Ruta. Thanks, Ben. Thanks, Roxana. Thanks, Mindy's. Thanks, everybody. Love you loads, guys. Bye for now.